Okay, let's get started. What we're starting with here is a clean version of OBS Studio. This happens to be version 27. We're also using a portable version of the software. If there's enough interest, put your comments below this video and we'll put together a video on how to make a portable version of OBS. It's quite handy, allows you to put multiple versions of OBS on your desktop at the same time. So, but as you can see here, here's our clean system with our scene to start. If we go to add a source to the scene, what we're looking for is the NDI source. And you can see that doesn't exist here yet. So we need to install that. There's actually two parts that we need to install to get OBS to support NDI technology. The first is the NDI toolset. So you can find that at this link, which is ndi.tv/tools. You'll click the download button here. It'll bring you to the bottom. This video is going to focus on Windows. So we would click on the download button here. There's some additional tools you can get on this side as well, but the ones that we need are in the main NDI toolset, which are these. You click on this download button, you will be required to enter some information and they'll email you a link. And ultimately, when you get that link, you will be able to install the NDI toolkit. So there'll be a link there. You'll install that like any other application. That actually gets NDI working on your PC, and you can use all those tools. But we still need to be able to get OBS functional with NDI. To do that, you need a plugin for OBS, and that plugin needs to be installed. So to do that, you can go to the OBS forum, and you'll find this OBS-NDI plugin. You click on go to downloads. Clicking on download will bring you to this page where you can then select the version of the plugin that you need for your system. We're on a Windows system. You can see there's two options for that. Most people should select the Windows installer.exe. That will install the plugin in the default location for most OBS installations. We're actually going to utilize the zip file version because we have a portable version of OBS, and I want to show you what it looks like after the plugin is installed. There's also a Macintosh package as well as a Linux package here as well, which won't be covered from the in this tutorial. Once you download those, what you'll end up getting is your .exe file. You can double click on that and install the drivers and tool set. We're actually going to use the this particular zip file. That zip file actually has the plugin files that we need to go into our clean portable version of OBS. The best thing to do at this point is, again, we still haven't installed the NDI driver, but what we should do is exit this because it's going to need to restart to be able to find the drivers. What we want to do is we want to copy the data and the OBS plugin right to the root of our OBS, our clean portable OBS version. So we've done that. We can close that. We can now reopen OBS. And now if we go, we can now see that we have an NDI source. So if we want to add an NDI source, we go here. We add the NDI source. And we can select any of these that we'd like. Let's select this one here. And that's it.
Thank you for watching. If you are watching this on YouTube, please click the like button to help others find this video.
As a Gymcom USA customer, please click on the subscribe button so you are alerted to other useful videos.
If you have any remaining questions, please contact us on gymcom.us.
Also, please post other topics you would like us to cover in the future.
Again, click on like and subscribe to this channel. Thanks again for watching.